Damari Gray scores! Mikel Antonio, and it's a goal!
And the Reggae Boys take the lead.
And Jamaica puts this one on ice.
If it's sunrise, don't rain on my parade. How are ya? In your beautiful... What color is this?
I don't know, Dennis. Why don't you tell me?
Orange and blue.
Look here. Good morning, gentle people. Good morning, my lovely co-host.
How are you?
Dennis walked in this studio this morning and says, I'm wearing coral. And I said, no, you're not. That's red. It's red.
Red?
It's red. It's really red.
It's just red?
However, this is coral.
Look here, I'm finished.
And turquoise.
And turquoise?
Yeah.
I'm finished. Good morning to...
But you look fantastic.
Thank you very much. I'm liking how your look is making me feel more comfortable.
Oh.
Yeah.
I mean, I hear that every day, but it's more the energy.
Look here, though. William Shakespeare said, April hath put a spirit of youth in everything. Ooh. And we're here this morning to make sure that you go into your Tuesday with a special youthful exuberance this morning. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
You know, my dad often says, so my dad is very playful and very childlike in nature. He's very no-nonsense.
Okay.
But that's when things require a no-nonsense approach. Mm-hmm. But in general, very playful. He's the grandfather that has a fart gun and walks around and like pulls the trigger behind the grandkids. And he's like,
Love that kind of person,
you know? And I remember one time as I said, Daddy, you're such a big kid. Like, why are you such a kid? And he said to me, I've never forgot this. He said, when the child in me dies is when I die. And I was just like, huh? And he's like, you have to keep the child in you alive.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
and when you get children and you become a parent, they preserve that certain element.
Yeah.
And you know what I always say to my friends, like especially my brethren who are fathers, I'm saying, imagine when we become grandparents, if we become grandparents, because if parenthood changes you, and it most certainly does.
Absolutely.
Then why wouldn't grandparenthood change you, you know?
Yeah.
Which is another reason why I love that, the blessing, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Because it is speaking to your generation. I know, like it's speaking to the your generations. And like, I, if you are lucky to see your generations, then you are really blessed.
I actually feel like that must be, it must feel like one of the greatest blessings to know that your seed has borne fruit.
Yeah.
It must be. I can only imagine, like when my father, I literally look at him and the pride that swells in him when he observes Israel and Isaiah.
Mm-hmm.
And I also have a nephew, Amir.
Oh, yeah?
I don't know if you guys know, but my middle name is Amira.
Uh-huh.
So, Amir is named after me.
Oh, yeah? I didn't know your brother had that.
So my stepbrother has a son.
Oh,
yeah, but I don't even refer to him as my stepbrother.
Yeah.
Because we've all been together for almost 20 years.
Mm-hmm.
But when the way he looks at us, and even the way my stepmom looks at us, or at the kids rather, the grandkids, you just know that it just is a different type of love.
Yeah, and that
even
is why they spoil themselves. That is why they spoil, because they see, like they can see it now.
Yeah.
They get it when they become grandparents.
And I also feel like with time and age and experience, there's a more rational, reasonable approach to things, and they're probably less stressed in their own day-to-day activities.
Mm-hmm.
And so you get a much more mellowed version.
And then
we observe our parents, like, who are you? And where is the person that you send me for the belt?
I love it.
Right?
Your girl in all her Ortonique glory, TK. T to the K, how are you? Happy new
Good
hair.
Good morning, great morning.
Not inside joke, going outside.
Happy new hair.
Why, thank you. This is Ortonique, Dennis. Mm-hmm. Are you sure about that?
I just made it up.
I know
just
that.
Made it up.
Don't I know it?
Yeah. Nice to see you all locked in, though.
Why, thank you. So,
can
we go to the headlines, please?
Double points.
You okay with that? Let's do it.
I am.
Let's do it.
Great morning, everyone. Eclipse Watch is our first headline. Sections of the planet were plunged into darkness yesterday for the first time since our last solar eclipse 7 years ago. No, but can you imagine ancient times, though, where that didn't have the scientific information, and the sun just goes dark in the middle of the day?
And
they must have
come,
and then comes back.
You know what I was thinking? I was thinking that ancient politician who first got the information in his ear, about the science and that it's coming, and then he
probably used it,
Dialogue, we got them.
All right, so next up, stroke victim receives help. So weeks ago, I think it was Trisha Gay Kelly's CVM News reported a story of a stroke victim, Norma Brown, living with her daughter, Alyssa, in a chicken coop. The family has struggled for some time now to financially sustain themselves due to Norma's physical condition.
Awesome. Love to see it. Love to see it. I love to see us. You know, no matter how... I've always felt this way about no matter how things tough and people not have it, when a real situation like this goes out, you always find people rally. Always rally and come around and support. So big up to that, and I hope that the funding goes where it's supposed to go, and we're not having people, you know, try to take advantage of anything, and because you always have hangers on and that kind of a thing. So I'm really encouraged about this. And you know what else?
What?
You see that young lady named Trisha Gay Kelly? I'm really impressed by the quality of work that she comes to work and does.
So, headphones on.
All right. All right. You ready?
Can you hear me now?
I cannot hear you.
Let's go.
Do you know what ASMR is? Well, it stands for Autonomous Sensory Meridian Response, and it's a deep state of relaxation that lots of people get from listening to certain sounds and watching certain visual triggers. I'm going to show you some of my most popular sounds and visuals. Ocean waves.
You know what's also really trendy right now is how they, have you seen them doing the eating ones? And they're like opening the wrapper and then you hear them crunching. And I'm like, I don't like to hear people chewing.
No, the mukbang videos with they're like you're hearing it at the back of their throat. It just makes you want to vomit.
How do you really feel about it?
This is, just things that like, when do you find time to do this? Like, when?
But you know what's really crazy? If you go on YouTube right now and look up ASMR videos, they have millions of views.
Choo-choo-choo.
It's not a train, it's Wayne. Hey.
Time is hard in the air today. But if you don't work, then you won't get paid.
Our days get a little complex sometimes. Often so many things make sense, yet so many do not. We are being intentional about giving prominence to the big stories in order to clarify and enlighten. Lead Story explains who, what, when, where, why, and how. Lead Story with George Davis, weekdays at 6:30 p.m. on CVMTV. No more fear of missing out. CVMTV News is on YouTube. Get up-to-date news, sports, and business content at CVMTV News anytime, anywhere. Subscribe now to CVMTV News to see it happen.
I've traveled the seas, I've traveled the waters. Once I was weak, now I'm stronger. I've worked in the sun, look what I've become. I've conquered the beast, now I'm much greater. I've learned from my failure. Dedication. Vision, discipline and drive. Seizing every moment that comes up in this life.
So this love was nurtured really by my parents, Maureen and Trevor. So you get the Trevine coming in.
Yes.
So my very first trip was when I was 8 months old to Germany.
Right.
And it has never stopped since then. I had the kind of parents who thought that travel was an extension of your education.
Absolutely.
So they were traveling. They were pulling us out of school, getting the assignments from the teachers because we needed to learn about the world as well as keep up with our homework.
I love
your
that.
Your mommy sounds like my type of lady.
I
need to speak with your mom. So we are going to dive into, if I'm not mistaken, you didn't start out doing this as a profession.
No,
you veered completely different from a different direction from where you started originally. Where were you professionally?
Well, I'm still there professionally. Have no doubt about it. I'm still a full-time lawyer. I travel, but now I am monetizing my passion for travel.
And then you started the travel company.
That's right.
Tell us about the travel company. What do you offer?
Well, it's a full service. So from the very basic, you just want a hotel stay, a flight, a cruise. We can do that for you. Or we create complete packages locally and overseas. We have partners all over the world.
That's really cool. That is very cool.
No.
All right, so we are going to do a little traveling today.
Sure.
Let's start out heading to Mexico.
No problem.
Tell us about the Mexican experience.
So spring is a wonderful time to be in Mexico. Many persons, when they think of Mexico, they automatically think about Cancun. Mm-hmm. And nothing is wrong with Cancun. It's very westernized. And yes, you want to see Chichen Itza and all of these sea notes. But there are other beautiful places in Mexico.
Yeah.
Los Cabos.
Yes. Oh, listen.
Puerto Vallarta. Country.
Hey, Trevita is my girl.
Los Cabos.
Yes. Mm.
Mazatlan. Yes. We heard about Mazatlan last evening with the eclipse.
Yes. Yes.
Very country, very lush. The people are wonderful.
So we are about to talk about the 21st century education, which is crucial for our young people to be able to thrive in what's coming. You know, we are embarking on a future, actually it's here now, where we're living with intelligent automated machines. So I'll say that again, intelligent automated machines. I was in Arizona a few months ago with my boy playing soccer, and we saw this car, and the car was driving, the car pulled over in front of us just before we were able to take a turn, and the car turned. And I said to my boy, Shiner, I said, Shiner, did you notice there were no drivers in that car? So this was an automated taxi. It was an intelligent automated machine. So when we hear about the future, we think about robotics and these evil things that's coming to us. No. We're talking about how do we exist at a time when technology is shifting the way we live, work, and play. And this conference is designed to train educators on how to prepare, how to think about our young people as they think about preparing them for a future that we're living in now.
Well, we're really excited to be working with Marlon from 21st Century Ed on this conference because we are Jamaica's premier STEM tertiary institution. And we've been producing STEM graduates for the last 65 years.
Yeah.
That's been our focus. And we now have to pivot because technology is changing so rapidly. And we've introduced new courses to keep up with what's happening, such as artificial intelligence, cybersecurity, and many others. Mm-hmm. And so what we want to do with this conference is to help Jamaica prepare for this transition that needs to happen, especially in the classroom, not just at tertiary level, but also primary and high school. So the conference will be for educators, teachers, principals, and in fact, one of our partners, the Ministry of Education and Youth, will be sponsoring over 100 teachers to attend the conference.
Excellent.
So that they can learn about all these technological changes that are happening. The conference is going to be workshop based, or the format. It's not going to be people
lecturing
you. It's
not a talk shop.
No.
Right. Yeah.
It will be hands-on, and we will literally be trying to give people practical examples of how they can introduce artificial intelligence.
Very UTEC.
And robotics.
Hands-on, practical.
So the children call me mommy. Everybody call me mommy. So I treat them like a regular home, because we're a home that we don't want the children to go further into the system if we can prevent that. Mm-hmm. So we prepare them to go back to integration with their family, And we also prepare them for those who does not have family and wanted to go into fostering. CPSFA made that decision or adoption. And we don't do adoption. You do have to go through the agency, right? So we have the children, we empower them because we have like girls. So what we do, we empower them to change. We don't just have them there. It's like a home. So it's a home with a lot of sisters and brothers. So our children right now, some of the girls have entered their school pageant and they're actually doing well because out of 30 children, they're in the top 10.
Nice.
And also, some of our girls, a few of them has been selected to go on the spelling bee.
Nice.
Right? So I am mommy. I drive them to school in the morning, make two trips, take them to school in the morning, pick them up in the evening, do what I have to do in between, like mommy, and ensure I'm at their parents' teacher meeting, I'm at sports, meetings, everything.
Really lovely.
Doctor's appointments.
Oh, look, yeah, got some goosebumps. I literally have chills.
Miss Paula, let me ask you as we go. I mean, I see you smiling.
Yeah.
This makes you happy, doesn't it?
It does. I'm in my calling, and I love the children. I do love them. I mean, my staff said, sometimes they say, go to your mommy, go to your mommy. And I do love them. I love what I'm doing. I have not decided that I want a vacation because I am mommy. You know, when you're a mommy and you don't want to leave your children.
Yeah.
And I don't think about other things than the children. With the support of my loved husband, and my children, my grown children, this is my calling. And my friends and Shelly and
it is beautiful when you're walking in your purpose.
It is beautiful.
God bless you.
Thank you so much.
That's the perfect song. Well done.
My corner office is a real life steering. It has the weight of a real life steering.
Right.
What is the Jamaica simulation racing?
It is the new form of racing.
It's time. Hold on. Full props.
The man is going
the
full
sun.
On.
I'm shades and the sun, you know.
Team I should have worked in less than 2 minutes.
Well, it is a thing that we, when you get these kids together, and you teach them the discipline. You teach them to honor your peers, honor the adult. And once they do it over time, they normally it instill in them and become part of them. So that's what we're really trying to achieve. It's not an overnight thing. It's not something that can be done in an instant. It takes time. Karate is like a lifestyle.
Yes.
Once you stop, you basically lose a lot from it. So we have to continue. And that's how we normally try to get the kids at an early age so we can instill that discipline in them. Yes.
When we're chit-chatting before we came on, one of your colleagues shared that my brother used to do karate. And I remember always observing not just the classes, but when there would be competitions. And it was almost like a dance. It's, you know, when you learn your, what's it called? Is it your kata?
Kata.
So you learn your kata and there's movement. And so it's not just what people say, your kick and your thump. But there's so much more to it. Walk us through what goes into it and what appears to be almost like a dance in these katas.
Okay. The kata, you have 26 katas in all, total, all right? And say for instance, the first one, Heian Shodan. Heian Shodan, you know, is a series of movement, 21 movement, moving left, right, and center, right? And you also have the application, the movement you're doing. For instance, you say, first movement you do that, right? It's a block. Second movement is a counter.
Yes.
All right, so karate basically, like for instance, block on counter.
Yes.
So, you know, you defend yourself, then you hit back. That's it.
Mm.
You understand? You don't keep hitting and so on and so on. And all the katas, you can get the bunkai out of it in terms that, you know, every single move, the application is there. board. Mm.
So I might add, it's an imaginary fighting style, basically.
Right, yeah, right.
So you really don't have the opponent, but you're actually fighting. Mm-hmm. That's what it is.
Mm. And you require, you still have to yes. use the level of force that you yes, would you were do. You to have yes. an opponent.
Right. Yes. Right.
I wonder if the block.
Our style is that a contact sport, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes. We punch as hard, as kick as hard, yes. but we stop.
Yes.
Because we believe in preserving our partners for tomorrow.
Got you.
Ian Shodan. Babe. Yoy. My count. Ich. Ni. San. Chi. Go. Huk. Chich. Ach. Ku. Ju. Ich. Ni. San. Chi. Go. Rook, sit, kiai. Yeah. Ach, two, two, itch. Damn it. Miss Milosh, wait. Yandy face Brandon. Hello. And Dennis will face Warren afterwards.
Okay, afterwards. Okay, good. Yeah, right, you go first.
So, let us see Yandy. Right leg stay back, ready. Right leg stay back. Left and out. Announce Jordan. Say Jordan.
Jordan.
Punch his face. One. Two. Sweet guy.
Say it. No.
Yummy.
Never.
Come on.
Oh, just kidding. Sorry, sir.
Yoy. Come ready.
Hey.
Announce Jordan.
Jordan.
He's going to punch your stomach. Stay back and block with your left hand.
Left hand, okay.
One. Two.
I don't know if you're blocking up. So.
Three.
No,
counter punch.
So. Yes.
Yeah, man.
Ha. Voila. Yeah. Yeah. Take down. Yeah. Don't mess with me.
So, Dennis, you're going to step back with your right leg.
Yeah.
Right leg, left hand. Yeah. Announce Jordan.
Jordan.
Punch to the face. One. No, stay there. Punch to the stomach. Two. Punch gay down, three KI. Good, yummy, good. Now he's going to do the same. Right leg step.
We'll start by cleaning the brows off.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Natasha, you have beautiful full brows.
She does.
I love a good eyebrow, must admit. Mm-hmm. Do you know that I actually read somewhere that the fullness of brows allows you to look even more youthful.
It does.
So they said the thinner your brows are, the older you look.
The older you look, and also if you have a nicer arch, you will also look more youthful as opposed to super straight or...
Tiffany, better give me an arch when we're done, girl. Because, woocha. All right, okay, so you comb it, you comb the brows we'll so you get it. Access to where you need to see for threading.
Right. So,
something like this, a service like this, you can demonstrate while you answer. How long would the process take the thread?
The process takes about 10 to 15 minutes. Can I borrow your hands?
Very quick service. Mm-hmm.
So, yes, it's a very quick service. This hand comes here.
This hand comes here.
Okay, this elbow goes out. Mm-hmm. And this one holds onto the eyelid.
Mm-hmm.
And...
And then get ready.
And
how do people who are interested, how do they book your services?
They can book by sending me a message on Instagram at FaceFramerJA.
FaceFramerJA. And again, you offer the full gamut. Threading, waxing, microblading, laminating.
Lashes.
Oh, you do lashes as
I
well?
I do, yes.
Did you do your own lashes?
I didn't.
Okay. I was going to say, your lashes look great.
Thank you.
Awesome stuff. Natasha, is it painful?
A little bit
painful, okay. But, Tiffany, would you say of all the services that you can receive, which one is the least uncomfortable?
Tinting. Tinting would be the least uncomfortable, yeah. Because you're...
What's your story? What's your sign? Your dreamers. Hear what other people say. We're doing this in our
Thanks for staying with us. Time flies when good things are happening or when great conversations are happening.
So true.
Yes, facts. And this morning the topic is Buy Jamaica, Break the Budget. But you know, it is time for our final thoughts. But before we go into final thoughts, let's just, and I want to start with you, right? Mm-hmm. How do we create a balance between supporting local and not breaking the budget? Look, when we look at the costs.
It's going to be a bit controversial. I am a firm believer in, I feel like we should make it difficult for foreign entities to penetrate our market, realistically speaking, because what that would do, it would tie into kind of forcing the higher-ups, the persons in power, to say, all right, we only have this here. What can we do to ensure that our populace can get access to these? Because, side note, I had some Jamaican grapefruit, some mandeville. And I'm still thinking about it to this day. Like, I asked, hey, I need some more next week. Like, there's just a testament to how good all our products are here. We're a beautiful people. We have everything here. And help us. We need... which one? We need...
Shalad, what do you
think? So how do you balance? I think it's finding... So, like, you know, coming off his... thought was that we do have good products here.
Yes.
And so I think, you know, you find one and two that's really good and you can invest in it or, like, you know, purchase it. So I have my key stuff that's Jamaican that I'm definitely going to
invest in.
You know, like, I buy support, it, a purchase. Yeah. And, like, if it's somebody's birthday, I'll buy it for them too. And so I have my things that I like that they're more of, like, a want.
Yeah.
Than they are. Okay.
Than they are a need.
Okay.
So, yeah. But that's how I try and balance it out.
And I'm where you are. I really do believe that anything that is grown here, mm-hmm. anything that we have here, mm-hmm. if it's going to be imported, I think that the tariff should be higher on it if yes. you're going to bring it in. So yes. we have strawberries. So if you're going to bring strawberries into Jamaica,
strawberries can
you
stay.
Should actually have... No, I'm just using it as an example. Okay. You should actually have to pay yeah. more money to bring yours in. Why? Because it grows here.
Yeah.
So we don't need it yeah. to be, we don't need it to be imported.
To
let them choose,
want.
Right. And yeah. I think that if we did that, then it would mean that those would be the things that were priced higher and mm-hmm. not the local goods yeah. being priced higher.
Exactly.
And it would also force us to buy more local products. So I definitely feel like I'm a big